Nityanandam paramasukadam kevalam jnanamurtim dvandvatitam gaganasadrusham tatvamasyadilakshyam ekam nityam vimalamachalam sarvadi sakshi bhutam bhavatitam trigunarahitam satgurum tam namami. Nityanandam, and welcome to today's episode of Living Advaita. Today I'd like to share with all of you one more example of how someone made it to inner awakening through will persistence. Of course, the awesome program Sadashivoham 2016 is coming up this December. That means maybe 3 weeks from now. Everyone, wherever you might live in the world, you still have plenty of time to get everything together and be here for this powerful energetic happening, this spiritual acceleration about to hit planet Earth. Now, Swamiji has very clearly defined what is real will power? Will power, as we typically think of it, the power we think of as power, declaring something is going to happen right now because I decide it. Swamiji says that is actually will arrogance. True will power comes through what Swamiji defines as will persistence, having the clarity and the understanding and the commitment with responsibility to decide that something is going to happen, it has to happen, there's no other choice, and that we will do whatever is necessary to make it a reality. I've shared this story before, but I'm going to share it again and again because it is my absolute favorite example of will persistence in action. One of my old YouTube viewers, a lovely girl named Heather, wrote to me once. She left a comment under one of my YouTube videos saying, "Oh my God, I have to get to inner awakening as soon as possible. Please help me." And please had a lot of ease in it. Please help me. She was desperate for inner awakening. I wrote her back and I asked her, "Why are you so intense that you want to come right now?" I was impressed, actually. I wanted to know, how did this intensity arise in her? And she said that she saw one of Swamiji's videos in which he said, "Anybody who attends inner awakening before the age of 21, the transformation they experience will be permanently established in their muscle memory. It will literally be a part of them for the rest of their life." At the time, Heather was 20 years old. She was turning 21 4 months from then. And the next IA that was coming up was in less than a month. The time the next IA would happen, it would be after her 21st birthday. She had that feeling of pressure, that feeling like it has to be now or never, the same exact feeling all of us are having with regards to Sadashivoham 2016. This is a once-in-all-lifetimes program. There is never going to be another Sadashivoham like this Sadashivoham. We are all in the same boat Heather was in back then when she was 20, knowing very clearly that she has to be at inner awakening by her 21st birthday. We're all in that same boat because now with these spiritual alchemy tools, Swamiji is guaranteeing that not only the experience we have, the transformation we have is going to become a permanent, established aspect of our lives forever. Even the powers we manifest, even enlightenment itself, this time that is going to become a permanent fixture of life. At the time Heather did this, Swamiji promised, he guaranteed, the transformation experienced will be permanent. At that time, what was the transformation? The transformation was into living enlightenment, being fully complete, completely complete, and unclutching. Now, it's a whole other level. It's a whole other context. Now what he's saying will be permanently established as a part of our lives from Sadashivoham is the state of Sadashivatva, realization of pure oneness with the highest cosmic divine being. Any word I try to give it in English is too small. but being one with Sadashiva himself and manifesting powers, seeing through the third eye, declaring reality and manifesting it through the words, doing what you want, making this whole world your playground because you are Sadashiva. When that experience becomes permanently ingrained in you, you'll have it made. Whether you're under 21 or over 101 doesn't matter. Swamiji is very clearly stating that this time, through the spiritual alchemy products he's giving to each participant, it will be a permanent transformation. In any case, Heather decided she had to be at the next Inner Awakening. What made Heather different from the majority of YouTube viewers of mine who were writing to me with the same question was that usually people would write to me and say, please make Swamiji give me a miracle. Make him send me the money. Make him cause somebody in my life to give me the funds. Usually people come from that perspective. They feel powerless and incapable of earning. So they say, please work some magic and give me the money to be there. What Heather asked instead was the will persistence question. She asked, what can I do to get this money? I will do anything. The moment she said, I'll do anything, I wrote her back a private message in Facebook. Those of you who are my regular viewers know that I don't do that. My inbox is too flooded. Messages will just get lost. But I wrote Heather a private message. And I said, you will be at Inner Awakening before you turn 21. I have no doubt. I am totally clear you're going to create this reality for yourself because you gave me that confidence in you by saying, I will do whatever it takes. So I asked her, where do you work right now? And she told me she didn't have a job. She lived with her parents. She had been going to university overseas. She had just moved back home again. I asked, okay, what do your parents do? One of them was in politics. One of them stayed at home. The one in politics was some kind of extreme right-wing Christian evangelical type. So I asked her. She said they have plenty of money. They have millions. No problem with finances in the family. But they will not give her a penny to come see a Hindu guru. If she wanted to go to some Bible camp or some Christian vocational college, I'm sure they would have paid for the whole thing, even if it was $50,000. But for Inner Awakening, they were not willing to budge. So she was asking me, should I try to convince them or should I do something else instead? I told her, do everything. Try to convince them, but decide that even if you don't convince them, you have a plan B, a plan C, a plan D. Start putting every possible wheel into motion. When we expand ourselves and stretch ourselves and do everything, it's then that existence truly fulfills us. The moment Swamiji can see that one of his Adinavasis is doing everything in his or her power to fulfill Guru Vak, to do Swamiji's instruction, he will just shower his grace on that individual. But if somebody is collapsing after trying to do one project without putting their full effort in, their full intensity in, he'll put that person into some kind of routine where they can learn integrity. Something happening right now with all of us in the Adinam. The way Swamiji micromanages his organization, he also micromanages the entire universe. When Swamiji in his cosmic form, in his Swarupa form, in his unmanifest form, beyond the form, which is not perceivable by the mind, when he sees that somebody who has set the Inner Awakening intention is applying for loans and taking on extra shifts at work and looking into their previous investments, calling back loans that they've given to others, asking those whom they know, applying for new jobs, starting businesses, selling whatever they're no longer using in life, we don't even need to sell what we love. Nobody is telling you sell your house and sell your car. Find out what's no longer relevant to you. Sell that, you'll get the funds for it. Actually, even before I finish Heather's story, there was a participant this past September. He attended this September Inner Awakening. He came from my YouTube channel. He was telling me on the first day that as soon as I was talking about Inner Awakening, he decided he had to make it. So he sent the intention form filled it in, declared that he's coming. The next day, he discovered that the property his grandfather had bequeathed to his father didn't want. Means his grandfather left this property as inheritance for his father. His father didn't want that property. He was a child at the time that this happened. The property got immediately shifted into his name, the next inheritor in the family lineage. Because the property was so irrelevant to his dad, the property is in India, these guys were living somewhere else. Because the property was irrelevant to his dad didn't remember to tell him, oh, by the way, there's a property deed in your name. Because he thought it was a useless land. When the guy found that property in his bank and realized it's in his name, and he asked his father, and his father said, you do whatever you want with it. The total value of that property came out to being more than the cost for September Inner Awakening and all the flights he needed and all the other expenses. Just like that, he sold the property and he came. What I'm saying is when Swamiji can see that we are stretching ourselves in every dimension to be around him to transform, he will create the opportunity for us. But first, before that opportunity is created, before the miracle moment happens, we have to use our will persistence and do everything in our capacity to get here. If you say to existence, give me a miracle, give me the money, I'll come if you give me the money. Existence only hears that last part of the phrase, I'll come if you give me the money. That makes it bargaining. That means it's not valuable to you. Imagine if you're a mother, you have a kid, and that kid's favorite food is chocolate cake. If you say to your kid, here, come eat this chocolate cake, the kid will say, yes, I'm coming. He'll drop whatever he's doing, even if he's playing on the iPad. Even if he's playing a video game, even if he's across the street at a friend's house, even if he's doing something privileged that he doesn't usually get to do, if you put a big piece of chocolate cake down and that's his favorite food, he'll come running. But if there's something that he kind of likes, kind of doesn't like, maybe some fresh fruit with whipped cream, maybe just as tasty to some of us, but maybe not that particular child's favorite. You might call him and say, come have this fruit salad I made. The kid will say, you know what, I'll come after I finish this video game. Or save some for me in the fridge, I'm playing at my friend's house right now. Or I'll eat it if you bring it to me. The moment the kid answers that way, the mother will know this is not the child's favorite and won't be bothered to try to reach that treat to the child. When we consider Inner Awakening or Sadashivoham, we have to be clear. This is the most powerful cosmic gift, the most divine treat available not only to humanity, but to any being in any dimension, on any planet, in any solar system, in any universe. The powers Swamiji is going to awaken in us through Sadashivoham are so great. We'll be able to manifest whatever we want the moment we want it. We'll be able to see through the third eye even while blindfolded. We'll be able to project any image into a mirror or onto a stone slab in three-dimensional detail, crisp like an iMovie, crisp like an IMAX movie. We will have powers that at this point in time, I won't even be able to think of to list out in this show. Imagine this program was some dessert and your mother is calling you to come eat this and enjoy. If you say, yes, I'm dropping everything, I'm running, that mother will be holding that piece of cake, holding that dessert for you, just waiting because she's going to see you enjoy it. She looks forward to see your smiling face as you bite and she's prepared it for you with love. The same way Swamiji is the cosmic mother. He has prepared these spiritual alchemy products with love. He's waiting to see you run and jump and join the program, dig in and enjoy. He's ready to manifest the powers through you. But if you have a casual attitude about it, saying, yes, Swamiji, I'll come transform, I'll experience these powers, you can give me that state of Sadashivoham, Sadashivo Hatva. You can give this to me if you give me the money, if you give me a miracle, if you create a situation in my life that makes it easy, then I'll come. What the hell kind of an attitude is that? No kid would turn down their favorite treat. No kid would turn down their favorite treat. No greedy person would turn down $1 billion free deposited into their bank account. I guarantee you, if you find a greedy person and you tell that greedy person, I have a $1 billion check with your name on it, but you have to drive to the other side of the city, meet somebody in a restaurant, introduce yourself, show your ID card, he'll give you this $1 billion check. Then you can deposit it into your account. If somebody tells you that, no doubt you'll be in your car that moment if you're somebody who runs after money. Hell, even if you're not somebody who runs after money, I would do it. Donate it to Sarvajnapita, put it straight into Swamiji's mission. If somebody offers you $1 billion and then says you have to drive for a couple of hours to get it, you'll jump in your car and start driving, right? If somebody offers you $1 billion and instead you say, yes, I want that $1 billion, but please drop it off in my account for me. I'm a very busy person. I don't have a car right now, and why should I have to pay the cab fare to get there? Why should I have to ask somebody for a ride? Why should I have to meet you at the restaurant? Can't you meet me on the street outside? Why do I have to deposit it into my account? Can't you give it to me in cash? If you ask those kinds of questions to get a $1 billion gift, that's exactly the same as what you're doing. If you tell Swamiji, I will come to Sadashivoham, but you have to give me a money miracle. Who says he has to give you a money miracle? Who says he's not already planning to give you a money miracle? That's the ultimate truth. He is waiting. There is enough abundance on this planet for every single seeker. Every single person who wants enlightenment, everyone who wants Sadashivoham to be their state, their go-to cosmic consciousness. There is enough resource here for all of us to experience Sadashivoham 2016. He is waiting to shower those miracles on you. But the secret of secrets, the ultimate secret that you need to understand in order to qualify for that miracle to happen, is that miracles do not come to those who casually shrug off the program and say, if I'm meant to be there, Swamiji will make it happen for me. No, forget that. I wanted to say a different F word than forget that just then. Forget that. Swamiji will give you the money miracle, but not if you're casual about it. You have to show that there is no other thought current in your mind but being here for Sadashivoham 2016. The essence of integrity is having only a single thought current, not two thought currents. Not, yes, I want to be there for Sadashivoham, but I'm not willing to bend myself and break my routine to get there. It has to be, yes, I want to be there for Sadashivoham, and I'll do whatever it takes. This young girl, Heather, I started the episode by describing. She took on 3 jobs. She stretched herself. She applied for loans at over 10 banks. At age 20, she didn't even have credit at the time. She got turned down and denied for loan after loan after loan after loan. But she kept applying anyway. And you know what? She was there in Haridwar for Inner Awakening before she turned 21. And when she got back to the U.S., immediately on arrival, she moved to her favorite city. She got a job making vegan smoothies. She got another job taking care of children of people who were just deciding to go vegetarian. So she had free room and board. She was basically a live-in nanny in a nice, beautiful mansion, plus with a day job on top of that. Within 3 months, she paid off all her loans. Within 6 months, actually, I don't know 6 months, but the next time she wanted to come to India, she came for Shivoham in 2015 May. She came for the Shivoham program. I asked her, what kind of money miracle happened this time? She said, no, Swarupa Priya, Actually, back then, I'll complete, my name was still Sudevi, the first name Swamiji gave me. She said, no, Sudevi, there was no money miracle this time. The money miracle Swamiji gave me during my inner awakening. He gave me the capacity to earn as much money as I want. Not only need want, I paid for this IA with no trouble. You can have the same thing. You'll get your money miracle. But first, decide to stretch yourself. Take on extra jobs. Work in every possible way you can. Apply for every loan. Ask everybody. When you stretch yourself, Swamiji will shower you with abundance. I promise you, I guarantee it. My integrity is on the line. I'm declaring it. Decide Sadashivoham 2016 is your only plan, your plan A, and there is no B, C, D, E, F, or G. Just get here. Decide with will persistence, you will make it happen. Swamiji will give you the miracle, and I'll see you December 1st. Thank you for tuning in. Nityanandam. Om Purnamadav Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudashyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Tat Sat. Sarvam Satguru Padukar Panamastu. Om Nityanandam.